Here's Devon Woodland, president of the National Farmers Organization, answering a reporter's questions about the purpose and goals of the NFO. The reporter is John Hart of the Heartland Project.
What we wanted to find out was how NFO is different from other organizations and what the basic goals are of NFO.
The goals of the National Farmers Organization is to establish our right to price. And the thing that makes us different from any other farm movement or group is that we neither buy nor sell any agriculture commodities. We negotiate the contract between the two parties representing the producer.
Why do you think it's necessary for such a group to be nationwide?
In order to deal with the corporations that are nationwide in scope, you have to be geographically as large as those companies are, or they'll circumvent your structure and buy their supplies from outside the geographic area in which you're organized, move it in where you're at, and use that to depress markets. So in order to be successful, you've got to be geographically as large as the major companies.
Why is the farmer pressing for the right to price his or her own commodities?
It becomes an economic issue. He must have his cost of production. And by our American standards, he's entitled to a profit. And so in order for him to retire debt, to continue to produce food, he must have an incentive. And that incentive comes only if he can retire his cost of production, and the incentive is that profit.
What are the major advantages of having a family farm as opposed to an investment corporation owning the land, and what are the causes of the decline of family farm, and how would you change that trend?
The importance of the family farm, or the private ownership, the owner-operator concept, is the thing that makes America different than any other country in the world and really makes us great. Is the people own America. And so we're losing something in society if we ever allow the ownership of land in agriculture, and we need to protect that. If we lose that, we have lost it all. And so our goal is to protect that private ownership because it's good for society, it's good for the farmer, and it's good for the American consumer.
What has caused that decline in private ownership? Why is the owner-operator going out of business?
It's economics. Because he has been placed into an environment in society where he cannot individually extract from the first buyer the costs equal, or a price for his good equal to what it cost him. And individually he cannot do that. But through group action, he can. And so this is the goal, it's the model, it's the battle cry of this organization. The National Farmers Organization is group action, and through bargaining, extract contracts from the first handler equal to the cost of production, and by our economic standard, by our society, we're entitled to a profit, and that's what we're going after.
That was Devon Woodland, president of the National Farmers Organization, answering a reporter's questions on NFO goals.
Here's Devon Woodland, president of the National Farmers Organization, answering a reporter's questions about the purpose and goals of the NFO. The reporter is John Hart of the Heartland Project.
What we wanted to find out was how NFO is different from other organizations and what the basic goals are of NFO.
The goals of the National Farmers Organization is to establish our right to price. And the thing that makes us different from any other farm movement or group is that we neither buy nor sell any agriculture commodities. We negotiate the contract between the two parties representing the producer.
Why do you think it's necessary for such a group to be nationwide?
In order to deal with the corporations that are nationwide in scope, you have to be geographically as large as those companies are, or they'll circumvent your structure and buy their supplies from outside the geographic area in which you're organized, move it in where you're at, and use that to depress markets. So in order to be successful, you've got to be geographically as large as the major companies.
Why is the farmer pressing for the right to price his or her own commodities?
It becomes an economic issue. He must have his cost of production. And by our American standards, he's entitled to a profit. And so in order for him to retire debt, to continue to produce food, he must have an incentive. And that incentive comes only if he can retire his cost of production, and the incentive is that profit.
What are the major advantages of having a family farm as opposed to an investment corporation owning the land, and what are the causes of the decline of family farm, and how would you change that trend?
The importance of the family farm, or the private ownership, the owner-operator concept, is the thing that makes America different than any other country in the world and really makes us great is the people own America. And so we're losing something in society if we ever allow the ownership of land in agriculture, and we need to protect that. If we lose that, we have lost it all. And so our goal is to protect that private ownership because it's good for society, it's good for the farmer, and it's good for the American consumer.
What has caused that decline in private ownership? Why is the owner-operator going out of business?
It's economics, because he has been placed into an environment in society where he cannot individually extract from the first buyer the costs equal, or a price for his good equal to what it cost him. And individually he cannot do that, but through group action he can. And so this is the goal, it's the motto, it's the battle cry of this organization. The National Farmers Organization is group action, and through bargaining, extract contracts from the first handler equal to the cost of production, and by our economic standard, by society, we're entitled to a profit, and that's what we're going after.
That was Devon Woodland, president of the National Farmers Organization, answering a reporter's questions on NFO goals.